KineMaster makes it super easy to create eye-catching video clips to promote business on social media. For example, here's a perfectly acceptable clip of some new jewelry. Yet with just a few clicks in KineMaster, we can turn it into something infinitely more eye-catching and interesting. Today, I'm going to share how to create high-impact social media ads you can use to promote your own business, or do what I do, and charge businesses to create these ads for them in three easy steps. When you're filming something small, a little extra movement can make all the difference, and an old fidget spinner makes a great base for a lazy Susan. I'm temporarily sticking this one to my old drum pad with a spare lens cap to give it some clearance. And if I just saved you some money, hit that thumbs up and show me some love. I shot this video on my iPhone 12 mini, which saves it directly to my camera roll for instant editing in KineMaster. But you can also shoot on a GoPro, a compact camera, a DSLR or whatever you like, and then you can import the footage into your smartphone or tablet for lightning fast editing in KineMaster. When you're editing videos for business, you want it to be quick and easy. The Projects tab contains a growing library of video templates available for download that really fast track a cool video production. Under marketing, I'm downloading this Cherry Blossom Festival project, which has a style I think could work well with my own footage. Download and open the project, and KineMaster will check to see if there are any other assets you need to make the project work. If there are, you can download them with a click. With all of the motion graphics, music, and sound effects used by the original creator laid up in the timeline, I can now decide which parts to delete or keep for my own project. For a quick win, let's click the first clip, select Replace, browse our camera album for our own footage, and select our first clip. Repeat that process to swap out all your footage. How easy was that? Notice that all of the clip durations stay the same as the original project. Keep everything in the right place. Now select a clip, select the Slip tool, and you can choose which section of your video clip you want to use, and I'll show you how to extend the footage shortly. I've got one final clip to add to the end, so let's place the playhead at the end of the video, select Media, browse to the clip we want, and tap to add it to the timeline. By way of a quick tour, this first track contains the primary footage. This yellow line over here is a text layer. This green layer is music. The next green layer contains sound effects, and all of these red layers are what we call stickers. When you click on an element, the playhead jumps to that position in the timeline and highlights the element with marching ants. So when I click on this second sticker, we can see that the sticker is a blossom graphic. These corner handles allow us to resize or rotate the clip, or tap on the trash to delete it. The Flower Festival text here is actually connected to this clip. Notice to the right, there are little red dots next to the active effects in the tool tray. Clicking Clip Graphic reveals the text Flower Festival, which we can select and edit. We can also select this A symbol to choose a different font, and there are more fonts available in the asset store, but more on that later. One final thing I need to mention is these yellow handles, which control the duration of the clip graphic. If I move them slightly to the left by dragging, the clip graphic will end here even though the clip continues. If you clip on the clip itself, it has its own set of handles and you can drag these to change the clip duration. Cool! If I select this second clip here and then click Clip Graphics, here I can edit the first line of text, or if I want to leave it blank, just hit the space bar. I'll edit the other text and that's looking great. You know, I quite liked the other text over the desaturated box, but I want a little bit more control, so let's create our own text layer. Select layer, text, and type away. Drag it into position. Then let's customize the font. Add an outline. And a subtle glow. These three dots over here allow us to duplicate the text layer, and we can drop the copy where it's needed. Now I've got my own text layers, let's change the clip graphic on my intro footage to give it a bit more pop. Select the clip, select Clip Graphics, then tap the back arrow to view the clip graphics on your system. It's probably a good time to mention that clipping this shopfront icon will take you to the Asset Store, where you can download even more fonts, backgrounds, images, stickers, music, sound effects, and of course clip graphics. Love letter number one has the pop I'm looking for this clip, and let's also animate our text layer by selecting the text, clicking the In Animation and choosing Letter by Letter. We can also select the Out Animation and choose an option we like. The clip graphic memory lane used on this footage could work well for my end clip too. Select the clip, select Clip Graphic and choose memory lane number 3, just to be a little different. So here is my final edit, with lots of movement to command attention on social media. And now I've created this first clip for my client, I can easily duplicate the project and change the aspect ratio depending on the destination channel. And of course I can use the replace tool to swap out for new products and quickly create alternate versions of this video, which is super cool. I'm Paddy, and if you liked this video, be sure to let me know with a big thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next video.